Today on The Nation Speaks, children have been spared the worst of the disease, but the pandemic has taken a terrible toll on their mental health. We likely won't know how bad for years, but our guests today give us some hints. We're joined by Dr. Mark McDonald, a child psychiatrist and author of United States of Fear, How America Fell Victim to a Mass Delusional Psychosis. And we have Oxford professor Carl Hannigan. He's looked at all the studies for a sweeping new report by Collateral Global. Then in America Q&A, we ask, how do you think the pandemic has affected kids' mental health? Finally, in our last America Q&A of 2021, we ask, what's the best thing that's happened to you this year? Hello and welcome to The Nation Speaks. I'm your host, Cindy Drucker. Statistics about the psychological toll of the pandemic on children are truly alarming. In a recent report, the U.S. Surgeon General says, according to early estimates, we lost more than 6,600 kids and young adults, 10 to 24-year-olds, to suicide in 2020. Now let that sink in. That's roughly 10 times the number of deaths for that age group that could be attributed to COVID-19. It's hard to imagine the level of despair, feelings of helplessness, isolation, and depression that these deaths must represent among kids nationwide. So the big questions are these. How much can be attributed to the trends that were already here, then made worse by throwing a global pandemic on top of the countless other societal factors? And how much can we blame on COVID mitigation policies themselves? And maybe more importantly, looking forward, what are the long-term impacts of what's happened already, and can we do better? We have two guests with us today to help us tackle these critical questions, questions we absolutely need to understand and answer if we are to avoid even worse consequences down the road. We're joined now by Dr. Mark McDonald, a board-certified child and adolescent psychiatrist and author of United States of Fear, How America Fell Victim to a Mass Delusional Psychosis. Dr. McDonald, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me on. I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you.
So the pandemic has had wide-ranging impacts. Life has been disrupted in multiple ways, probably for children most of all. From where you're sitting, what do you think are some of the biggest psychological impacts, particularly that children are suffering and might suffer long-term?
Well, one of them is clearly social. I have a lot of adolescent and younger patients in my practice, and their social capacity to attend, to be attentive, to express their feelings, their emotions, to tolerate social discourse, social distress, has really been affected by being locked at home, kept away from school, and masked for the last 18 to 20 months.
So how are you seeing that manifest?
Well, what I see in my practice is children who refuse to make eye contact, who are wetting their pants or wetting the bed at night, cannot go to sleepovers, being away from their mother for extended periods of time. And then in the older group, in the teenagers, they are so wrapped up in social media and phones and Zoom school because they've been trained for the last year and a half that they do not even want to go out anymore. They don't want to play sports. They don't want to see movies. I had a family just yesterday, father that has an 8-year-old and a 10-year-old, come to me and he said, you know what I just heard from my children? I took them to a water park and they said to me, Daddy, when are we going to go home? He said, what do you mean go home? And they said, I'm almost up to the 12th level on my video game. And I really, really, really want to go to the next one. And he said, all right, we have a problem now. When children are at a water park and they want to leave to go back to their gaming system, something is seriously wrong.
The title of your book, United States of Fear, obviously you've identified fear as a major problem during this pandemic and the messaging. How is that impacting kids from what you see?
Well, children have been now trained or groomed to be afraid. And I really do blame parents for this. Obviously, government is a serious problem. Government has imposed these mandates far and wide, particularly in urban areas. But the last line of defense for a child's emotional and physical well-being is the parent. And many parents have been complicit in this. They have transferred, or in psychological terms, projected their own fears and anxieties onto their children. They have used their children as a foil to calm their own nerves. And I said this as early as May of 2020, when the schools were closed at the Orange County School Board of Education meeting, reopen the schools, keep the children normal, and stop abusing them. Parents have actually, in my view, literally abused their children by keeping them at home and forcing them to wear masks because it makes them feel better. And that's wrong.
One of the things we often hear is that kids are resilient. They can bounce back. What's your reaction to that?
Absolutely, children are resilient. They have very plastic brains. They go through stages of development where their neurons are growing and pruning and growing and pruning like little trees. You think of them as fruit trees that gardeners cut away the overgrown branches in order to let the younger ones and the ones that are more apt to bear fruit grow more strongly. That's how we grow and develop. That's completely normal. So I'm not pessimistic to the sense that we're going to see guaranteed a generation of children locked in their parents' basements, as I have said in the past. However, it's very, very, very important for children to, as soon as possible, be brought back onto a healthy path, to be put back in school, back in playgroups, allowed to breathe freely, to see faces. Because if we persist in this over the long term, if we maintain this state of deprivation of neural growth and neural development, we really will see a generation of children who are socially and, sadly to say, somewhat brain damaged growing up. And I don't want to see that.
Let me ask you this. One of the things that I've thought about during this pandemic is that it seems that we're creating a society, and certainly children throughout this, that have become very risk adverse and compliant as well. You know, kids are sitting in their isolated circles, they're wearing their masks, they're looking a certain way, they can't play like this, they have to play like that. What do you think the impact of that is? Am I correct? Am I off base? And what do you think of that?
I think it's an excellent point you're making. And I would say that this is unfortunately nefarious and intentional. I think that government, media, corporations have created a behavioral conditioning program for children to do absolutely irrational, ridiculous things that they never, ever would have agreed to before, like playing football or soccer with face masks on, marathon running without being able to breathe, sitting outdoors, as we saw recently, in a New York City school in 40-degree weather, eating lunch in the rain outside on buckets. And they agreed to do this because they were told, this is how you keep yourself safe. This is how you keep your parents safe. I had a child who said to his mother recently in my practice, "Mommy, my teacher brought one of my classmates to the front of the classroom and praised him for getting his vaccination. All the children applauded. He went back to his mother and said, 'Mommy, why won't you let me get my vaccination? I want to be like him. I want to get applause and praise too.'" This is really, really sick. And children buy into it because they want to be accepted socially and they want to be praised by parents and other authority figures. We must see as parents, as adults, what's happening to our children, how they're being programmed ideologically to fit a mold that may not conform with our values. And we need to put a stop to it. I would even say we need to take our children out of government schools and put them back in the home.